प्रिया श्रीवास्तव फ्रॉम अपोलो क्लिनिकल्स हॉस्पिटल कोलकाता। नेक्स्ट, आर हॉस्पिटल इज अ मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी टर्शरी केयर 750 बेडेड फैसिलिटी एंड एज अगेंस्ट द एनएचएस एंड बेंचमार्क ऑफ जीरो, आर एनएसआई रेट वाज बिटवीन 0.71 टू 1.28 पर 100 बेड्स। एनालिसिस एंड ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग सेशन वर डन एंड वी केम अप विद अ टीम ऑफ 26 चैंपियंस फ्रॉम डिफरेंट डिसिप्लिन सच एज डॉक्टर्स, नर्सेस, हाउसकीपिंग एंड टेक्नीशियंस। नेक्स्ट, these injuries, problem definition, these injuries can lead to mental agony for the staff, increase morbidity for the patients and staff, may reduce productivity and performance of the hospital. Next, problem diagnosis was done by the needle stick by the fishbone analysis and Pareto charts, which showed nursing had the highest incidences. The pie chart showed that the ICU were the place where the highest incidences took place. Next, Sharp's safety survey were done throughout the hospital. Next, sharp handling and disposal practices were done. Audit was done and we arrived to our problem statement. Next, risk analysis was done. Physical, financial, social and environmental causes were outlined. Next, Project Shubchintak, poster was displayed all throughout the hospital. The Swiss cheese model was used, and systemic problems such as staff shortages, inexperienced team members, failure to monitor vital signs was identified. Next, the underlying processes and practices which went wrong were recapping, passing suture needle or sharps in the OT directly, improper waste segregation, not using PPEs, a certain casual approach at work, tendency to hurry in activities, staff unaware about the use of safety devices. Next, from the patient's perspective, infected patients can injure the staff, and which can lead to other patients getting infected. The cost to company was also a great problem here. Next, so the problem remedy was, we did was to apply a timeline and a control plan was made. The chosen 26 members were trained and given assigned various areas in the hospital and onset of Project Shubchintak. Next, so these six steps were done: develop organizational capacity, assess program operational processes, prepare baseline profile, determine intervention, develop action plans, and monitor the performance improvement. Next, so the project flow was made, and responsibility of the champions was to disseminate the learning, random assessment, regular observation, monthly meeting, and trainings. Next, so this was the training schedule which was made, and hepatitis B vaccination was made mandatory. Next, the waste segregation posters were displayed, and training of the staff was done. Next, reporting of NSI was done, and the needle stick injury information form was created, which was done by the quality department. Next, needle stick injury protocol was developed, and best practices were identified, such as immediate staff sharp disposal, proper handling of garbage bags, use train, placing and retrieval of use sharp, extra caution near disoriented patients, avoid recapping of needles, and avoid carelessness at work. Next, safety devices were used, such as safety cannula, in which the stilet gets guarded when it's once it's taken out. Eclipse needle was used, puncture proof gloves was given, display of educative posters and training sessions were done. Next, the supply of safety devices were ensured. Next, the cloning and improvement by daily leadership round and clock quality audits, regular team meetings, discussion and plan of action formulated in the morning huddle. Next, staff retrainings at periodic intervals and during annual infection control week. Next, the final control chart showed that this had reduced to a great extent starting from April to December 2019. Next, cloning the improvement at the leadership huddle at 9 a.m. daily. We looked at the operational aspects and organizational and discussion of the staff injuries. Processes and devices were replicated and introduced in the hospital. Staff awareness was induced and the seriousness of the problem was implicated. Next, these are the tangible results. Process improvement, low cost of poor quality, decreased spread among patients, improved the productivity of employees. Next, intangible results. This impacts everything from patient safety, quality and service delivery to innovation, problem solving and financial performances. Next, the cost savings were monthly 50 lakhs per month and annuals of 60 lakhs annually. And this barring the amount of mental and physical trauma that the staff is subjected to, the cost of utilization of additional hospital resources, manpower, cost of attrition due to frustration of the staff, and the opportunity cost if the injury does not get reported and spread from staff to staff and staff to patient. Now, cost to the patient. While a normal needle costs 2.50 rupees, a blunt fill needle costs 3.50 rupees, only increase of 1 rupee, and the eclipse needle costs 4.50 rupees, which is increase of ₹2. So the cost of normal.
Ma'am, 1.5 minutes to wrap up, please.
Yeah, cost of normal vein flown is 120 rupees, which is used for 3 days, while the pro safety cannula costs 340 rupees, and it can be used for 5 to 7 days. Normal gloves used by housekeeping cost ₹2, and it is single use, whereas puncture proof heavy duty gloves cost ₹140, which is washable and it can be used multiple times. So thus the patients were explained about the minimal change in their billing, and it was found that 90% were happy to incorporate the safety devices into their care. The continuous engagement of the patients and the family towards patient civilization to procedures and waste segregation contributed to the project. A culture of safety was established throughout the hospital. Process alignment and uniform procedures decreased. Increase in OP and IP volume significantly. There has been no major tariff escalation in the past 1 year, though the per patient net revenue has increased. Lastly, a happy staff leads to a happy patient. Thank you. Next.
Initiative. My question
Thank you,
is-
sir.
In the initial stage, you said that it was more common in nursing and yes, more sir. Common in ICU setup. Did you find out what was the root cause?
Yes, the nursing staffs were the one who primarily used the needles, and the process of waste, disposal of waste was not proper. They were very callous in their attitude, and there was carelessness involved, and especially in ICUs, because there's a lot of pressure in the ICUs for all the staff that is involved there, and therefore tendency to hurry in the activities led them to not to do proper segregation of waste, and there was one incident where a nurse had just thrown the needle to the dustbin.
Have you addressed this hurry factor in the ICUs?
Yes, sir. Regular trainings have been done. We have introduced reward processes for the staff and the supervisors.
One more question for you.
Yes, sir.
To what extent it was not reported from other professionals like doctors and housekeeping staff?
Sir, it was reported. We ensured that it was reported because the further we had inculcated into them that this was a life-threatening problem, and the treatment for it was absolutely free for all the staff. So it was. We made sure that the seniors or whoever was around the staff and the staff herself reports the incidents.
Thank you.
So I have a question. You mentioned somewhere, I'm a little taken aback. You mentioned somewhere that you started giving hepatitis B vaccination. You are a Joint Commission International NABH accredited hospital. Isn't that part of your normal practice? Why did you have to initiate that?
Yes, sir. We just made sure that everybody had got it because before that, so that no staff was left out. It is a procedure.
So it was going on, sir. Fine. Thank you. I don't have further questions, and neither do our esteemed panel of judges.
Thank you, sir.